Welcome to programming with Python in the Spider environment. In the previous video we looked at lists. Now we're going to look a little bit further with lists, and especially things you can do with lists, or more what you can do to a list. And before we really start with that, I want to show you one nice trick. What we saw in the previous video is how we can print the individual items from that list. But we can also just print a list, and that's what we're going to do here. So I've added print name, and let's see what happens. So this is the first three, Bart, Piet, Jan, is what we did here. That's clear. And if we just print the total list, we're going to see it like this. Which is, it's possible that you want it like that, or it's possible that you want to have it differently. But it's nice to that you can use this statement to have a quick overview of what is in the list. Okay. Now we're gonna cover an extra item. You can also add items to the list. And the way you do it is like this. You do it by appending something to the list. Let's say I want a Bart, Piet, Jan, so what's more case. That's also a nice touch name. If I'm now printing it, you can see that I've added case to the list. I can also add Bart again to the list. So if I now run it again, then you can see that you get Bart, Piet, Jan, Bart. Bart, Piet, Jan, Bart. Okay. You can remove items also by the list. You can do it by pop. So name dot pop and etc. But I'm going to show you something different. I'm going to show you something. I'm going to show you remove. And I'm first going to show you how, if I want to remove, for instance, Piet. So what I did with this list, I have Bart, Piet, Jan. Then I added Bart, and then I'm going to remove Piet. So let's see what happens. And indeed, in the final list here below, you see that, well, Piet is removed. Okay, let's now see what happens when we remove Bart. And I'm gonna run again. And something peculiar happens. Only the first Bart is removed, as you can see. So remove is useful, but it only removes the first occurrence of the item in your list. So there's a lot more you can do with lists, but we're going to change to a different type of list, more specifically an array using NumPy's, and we're going to look at that in the next video.